All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory due to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Waharakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and salutations to the hopeful elect out here toiling in this truth. I'm Bathaka Moth Jim S. Dallas, and I'm just coming back at you with a really quick hit lesson. Just dealing with these Christians again, man. You know, they just don't get the whole heaven and hell concept, you know. They think that the kingdom of heaven is going to be in the clouds, you know what I'm saying, with the heavenly father, as well as they believe that hell is going to be in the ground, man, in the center of the earth, in some flaming fire, which is just not biblical, man. The kingdom of heaven will be here on earth. So, you know, just real quick, you know, I just want to, you know, real quick lesson, man. Hopefully this, you know, it's not going to be anything too long or drawn out. But just to make an impactful point, you know, I'm just going to start right here in the book of Ezekiel. And I'm going to drop down to verse 21 and just get to the point, because, of course, the book of Ezekiel, the 37th chapter, is going into the dry bones, you know, basically waking up and coming back together, the split nation, southern and northern kingdom, you know, the so-called Negro tribes and the so-called Native American and Hispanic tribes coming back together and coming back into one, the two separated kingdoms coming back together as one kingdom, which is the kingdom of heaven, going into the kingdom of heaven. So I'm going to start right here at verse 21, you know, because they've been given this knowledge, that breath has been put back into them, you know, which is this knowledge. And they, and again, like the scriptures say here in Ezekiel 37, they stood upon their feet, a great, exceeding great army, Salaki. And, you know, that's what's happening right before the eyes of these people. But this is dealing with right here on earth, man. It's happening right now, man. You know, and these people can't even see they don't realize what they're looking at, man. You know, and they want to point fingers and call us crazy and all kind of, you know, wilding out. But they're watching prophecy play out right before their eyes, man. You know, so I'm going to just get to the point. This is Ezekiel 37 and 21. I'm going to read all the way down. And it reads, "And say unto them," who is the Israelites, it's going to go into it, "thus, which the Israelites consist of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians of Negro descent. You make up the 12 no longer lost tribes in these times. We know who we are now." You know what I'm saying? So Ezekiel 37 and 21, "And say unto them," the Israelites, "thus saith Yahweh Bashem Yahshai power, behold, I will take the children of Israel," there it is, "from among the heathen, whither they be gone, and will gather them on every side and bring them into their own land, because the Lord scattered us because of our transgressions, going against him," man. You know, idol worship and different things Jake loves to you know, dabble in, you know what I'm saying? All forms of it, you know, from Egyptology to Catholicism to Islam, you know, 5% is all kind of, you know, madness, man, you know, which is idol worship, man. You know, so Jake has been into these things going all the way back, man. You know, it's no new thing under the sun, man. You know, that which was then is now, man. You know, Ecclesiastes 3 and 15. So it says he's going to gather us from every side, because when you read in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, verse 64, the Lord, which is part of the curses, the Lord says, which the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, basically is heaven and hell, man. The first 14, you know, 1 to 14 is your heaven, you know, all the blessings. And then 15 through 68 is your hell, the affliction, the curses, you know, being destroyed, man. You know, so that's heaven and hell in a nutshell. Deuteronomy 28 and 1 through 68. And when you read in Deuteronomy the 30th chapter in verse 1, it tells you that we were set to go through both, man. You know, we were both were set for us before us. You know what I'm saying? So it says he's going to gather us from all these places. Deuteronomy 28 and 64. He was going to scatter us from one end of heaven to the other, among all these nations and people. You know, Leviticus 26 and 33. You know, Hosea 8 and 8. You know, we're going to be swallowed up of the heathen. It says, and bring us. So he's going to gather us from every side and bring them into their own land. You know, of course, Matthew 24. In verse 31, you know, the Yahweh Shai said he was going to gather us from one end of the heaven to the other. you know. And it says to bring us into our own land. That reminds me of Isaiah the 14th chapter, man. The Lord said he was going to yet choose Israel and set them in their own land, man. You know what I'm saying? Which that hasn't happened yet. Those fakes in the land over there, they were put over there by way of the Balfour Declaration. Those 1948ers, those small hat, you know, little hatters, you know, they didn't get put over there by way of prophecy. They got put over there by way of a lie, man. You know what I'm saying? So the Lord is going to put us back in our own land. That's happening here on the earth. That ain't got nothing to do with the spirit realm. That ain't got nothing to do with dying, man. Being placed back in a land, you know. And this is going into the kingdom of heaven right here, man. It says, and I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king over them all, King David, and they shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms anymore at all. So there'll be no more splitting of our nation, man. You know, us coming back together, which that's happening right now before their faces, and we'll never be split apart ever again, man. A perfect nation, righteous nation. That's coming, man. It's happening right now. Verse 23, neither shall they defile themselves anymore with their idols. There it is. Nor with their detestable things. You know, the eating pork and the abominations, celebrating these holidays, all the things Jake does, commit adultery and, you know, nor will any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places wherein they have sinned, which is everywhere Jake is right now, man. Here, primarily here in America, man. We're going to be saved. And that's what salvation is, man. Being saved from our enemies, man. You know, Luke, the first chapter goes into that. You know, the Lord said he was going to save us from our enemies and from all the hands of those that hate us, roughly paraphrasing, you know. And it says, and I will cleanse them. So shall they be my people, and I will be their power. Verse 24, and David, my servant, shall be king over them, and they all shall have one shepherd. They shall also walk in my judgments and observe my statutes and do them. Jeremiah 31 and 31 on down. And Hebrews, the 8th chapter, man. You know, we can get the law, statutes, and commandments put in our inward parts, man. You know, we won't have to teach Israel anymore, man, because they're going to have it in them. It's going to be automatic. That's the kingdom of heaven, man. That's what we're reading right here. That's here on earth, man. And they shall dwell in the land that I have given unto Jacob, my servant. Now, what does that have to do with dying, man? You don't dwell in lands when you're dead, you know? So heaven is going to be here on earth. And they shall dwell in the land that I have given unto Jacob, my servant, wherein your fathers have dwelt. And they shall dwell therein, even they and their children and their children's children forever, which proves children will be happening in the kingdom of heaven for these numbnuts who think there won't be any sex in the kingdom. They're out there, goddamn minds, man. They're bugged out. Jake is through. And my servant David shall be their prince forever. That's another point, too. Children, having children is not something you do in the spirit realm, man. You know, you don't do that in when you die. You ain't have no children when you die. So how are children and their children, come on, man, forever? No, man, that's talking about right here in the flesh on earth. Of course, we won't be in this flesh that we're in now. You know, we're going to be superhumans on the flesh. But, you know, part celestial, part terrestrial, you know, supermen and Wonder Women on the planet. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, nevertheless, it's going to be here on the earth, man. You know, and David shall be their prince forever. Moreover, I will make a covenant of peace with them. It shall be an everlasting covenant with them, and I will place them and multiply them and will set my sanctuary in the midst of them forevermore. My tabernacle also shall be with them. Yea, I will be their power, and they shall be my people, and the heathen shall know. And the heathen shall know that I, Yahweh Bashmiah, shall do sanctify Israel when my sanctuary shall be in the midst of them forevermore. And these heathen are going to know, man. That's all these things are going to play out in the earth, man. You know, these are all things that are going to happen right here on the earth. And we're in the process in the midst of that happening as we speak. You know what I'm saying? So the kingdom of heaven is going to be right here on earth, man. You know, and when you read in Daniel, the 7th chapter, just jump down to verse 27 real quick. What does it say? Daniel 7 and 27. And the kingdom, rulership and dominion, and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven. Under the whole heaven. You ain't going into the spirit realm. Under the heaven, you know. Earth is under the heaven, man. When you look up, you see heaven above. So earth is below, beneath it. So under the heaven is right here on earth, man. Under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High. Given to the people of the saints of the Most High. And of course, we know the saints are the Israelites. Psalms 50 and 5, Psalms 148 and 14, Psalms 149, 1 and 2. You know, they're the Israelites, man. But it says given. So is the Lord going to give the spirit realm to the Israelites, man? Come on, man. No, this is not dealing with dying, man. This is dealing with right here on the earth. Rulership of the earth is going to be given to the saints by way of our big brother Yahawashi, man, who is an Israelite of the tribe of Judah, man. You know what I'm saying? Hebrews 7 and 14. He sprang out of Judah, man. You know? So he's an Israelite. You know? And he's pursuing the Psalm, the second chapter. His inheritance is the uttermost part of the earth and everything in it, the heathen, everything in it, man. That's it. That's his inheritance. And he's going to share that and join there with the elect, with us. Lord willing, I can be a part of that. Romans, the 8th chapter, verse 17, Revelation, the 2nd chapter. You know what I'm saying? So it says, shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom, that rulership, because it's what Yahawashi is coming to do, take rulership, possession of the earth, Revelation, the 19th chapter. You know, he tells you he's coming to judge and make war, man, you know. And there's going to be a war, man, because that's how you basically take possession and rule something, man. You fight, you know, and if you win the battle, then you have conquered. Now you're the ruling class, man, you know. And as a matter of fact, once I finish this, I'm going to jump up. It says, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominion shall serve and obey him. Yahawashi. When you jump up, it reminds me of verse 18, Daniel 7 and 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. Take it and possess it. Fight war, man. You know what I'm saying? When you win the battle, you rule. You know what I'm saying? And that's what Yahawashi is coming to do. You know, he's coming to judge and make war. That's why that's Revelation, the 19th chapter. And that's why when you read in Revelation, the 12th chapter, you know, in verse 7, it goes into that war in heaven, man, where Michael and his angels fought against the dragon and his angels, man, represents Esau and his military and these heathen militaries, man. You know, we're still going to lose, you know, and the saints are going to fight and take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. You know what I'm saying? Which goes into that dominion in the 27th verse. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, taking dominion, man, you know, and our forefathers knew that, man. And all these things is talking about happening in the earth, man. You know, it's Acts chapter 1 and verse 6. And it reads, when they therefore were come together, talking about the disciples with Yahawashi, they ask of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? You know, so it says restore the kingdom again to Israel. You know, restore means to bring something back, and again further reiterates and goes along with that to further back it, man. So restore, to bring back again the kingdom, proving that we had it before. How do you die, you know, all to the Christians, these are questions. How do you die and get something again if you only live once? That makes no sense, man. You know, they don't believe in reincarnation. They're getting everything wrong, man. You know, so to restore means to bring back again. So bring back the kingdom again to Israel. You know what I'm saying? Proving that they understood it, man. Back then, they understood that what the kingdom was. And you know, they were asking him, when are we going to get the kingdom back? Rulership again. When are we going? Because they had it during the time of the Dark Ages, man. They understood that. You know, that's what the Dark Ages actually represent. The dark rulership, the dark rule. You know what I'm saying? So, and of course, kingdom means domicile of the king, man. You know what I'm saying? That's a rulership, domicile of the king, you know? So, and during that time, the Roman Empire was in rulership. You know, so they were asking when they were going to be taken down and us being put back into power today, which those Romans slash Greeks are in power to this very day, man. They're still ruling to this very, very day. You know what I'm saying? But they understood its rulership, man, of the earth, you know? And when you read in Daniel's, Daniel, the fourth chapter, in verse 17, what does it say? It says, this is Daniel 4 and 17. This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, the angels, to the intent that the living may know, the living right here on earth. You live on earth in this flesh. We're alive. We're living right now. The intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, domicile of the king. That's the rulership, man, here on earth among men. And giveth it to whomsoever he will, and setteth up over it the base of men. And of course, Job 9:24, the earth has been given into the hand of the wicked, or the power of the wicked. They're the current rulers, man, you know, and they're the basis of men. Job, the 30th chapter, goes into that. You know what I'm saying? They're viler than the earth, you know, base men, children of base men, children of fools, you know. So it's in their hands right now. But it's all of these things are talking about here on the earth, man. As a matter of fact, in the book of Psalms, the 75th chapter, in verse 6, it says, for promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. But the Most High is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another. Yeah, when there's a war, he'll have one that was ruling, and this new nation comes in and conquers that nation. That's putting down one and setting up another, and then they're currently ruling. As a matter of fact, when you read in the book of Daniel that I just had, the previous verse I had, Daniel the 7th chapter goes into four major empires or kingdoms, beasts, if you will. That would rise and fall, rule and be conquered, you know, set up and taken down before the implementation of the kingdom of heaven. You know, the Babylonians, the Medo-Persians, the Greeks, and the Romans, you know, and we're in the last leg of the Roman Empire, because a little horn came out of them, which is America, represents America, man, which we're on the last leg of that little horn, man. You know what I'm saying? So this thing is done, but all these things are talking about right here in the earth. You know, when you go into history, the Babylonian Empire, that happened. The Medo-Persian Empire, Cyrus and Darius, that happened, man. This is all history. You know, the Greeks under Alexander, that happened. You know, the Romans, you know, with your Senate and your presidents and everything, how everything America has set up. That goes back to those Romans. That happened. That's why they're doing it to this very day. These things happen in the earth. So these things are talking about right here in the earth. So the kingdom of heaven is going to be right here in the earth, man. It's not going to be in the spirit realm, man. You know, as a matter of fact, didn't the Lord say he was going to make us a nation of kings and priests? You know, domicile of the king. The Lord said he was going to make us a nation of kings and priests. Which reminds me, let's get these last few in real quick. This is Revelation chapter 5 in verse 10. And it reads, and has made us into our power kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. Reign and rule is the same thing. We shall reign slash rule on the earth, man. You know, the Israelites, because the Most High said he was going to make us a nation of kings and priests, man. So it says, and has made us unto our power kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. That's a future prophecy. We're coming into these times. This hasn't happened yet. But it says we're going to reign on the earth, man. Rulership of the earth. That's what the kingdom of heaven represents. You know what I'm saying? And when you read in Matthew, the 5th chapter, what does it say? It's Matthew chapter 5 and verse 5. Blessed are the meek, which the meek means lowly. The Israelites were on the bottom of this society, you know, in the ghettos, on the reservations, and the projects. Ain't got a went pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of. It's talking about Jake, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians of Negro descent, man. The tribes, you're the meek. So it says, Matthew 5 and 5, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Man, beginning to start with our big brother Yahushua. His inheritance, Psalms, the 2nd chapter, is the uttermost part of the earth. and the heathen for his inheritance, man, for his possession. You know, joint heir, man. Romans 8, Revelations 2, you know. So it's going to be right here on earth, man. All of these things is talking about right here on the planet earth, man. Not in the spirit realm. Christians, it's Revelation chapter 20 and verse 4, and it reads, "And I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Yahweh Shai," going to the elect, "and for the word of the Most High, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads," those 7,000 men that didn't bow, or in their hands, and they lived, hello, to the intent that the living may know. All these are dealing with living, you know, right here on earth, reigning, kings and priests, and we shall reign on earth, you know, the meek shall inherit the earth. All these things are talking about right here on the earth. "And they lived and reigned, ruled with Yahweh Shai 1,000 years. And that's going into that first 1,000 year period of getting the earth back into that paradise state. You know, ain't got nothing to do with translating, man. You know what I'm saying? There's some bugged out groups out here, man. So let's get one more. We're going to jump over to Revelations 21. It's Revelations 21 and 1. I'm going to read a few verses down. And it reads, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, refreshed heaven and a refreshed earth." When you go into the words new, you know, "For the first heaven and first earth were passed away." This current system and society, this current rulership set up kingdom that we're in right now, it's going to pass away, man. Esau is the end of the world, but Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. 2 Esdras 6:9. "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea." You know, the Lord is going to empty this place out, man. You know, it's going to be few people left, man. He tells you that in Isaiah, the 24th chapter. You know, he's going to empty the earth, man. You know, because you can't take, if you're going to make everything new, keep the old. You know, it's out with the old. They got that saying here, out with the old and with the new. That's how the Lord feels. Out with the old and with the new. You know, they're going to have to be taken out. And then there's going to be remnants left. You know, of course, the remnant of Israel is going to be righteous, and they're going to implement that righteousness throughout the remnants of these nations that are left. And when by the time everything starts coming back in, you know, by way of reincarnation, you know, with the Israelites, they're going to get it put in them, or it'll be automatic. But with these nations, from that remnant that was getting their ass beat, they're going to know what it is, man. And they're going to instill that throughout the generations. You know, so it says, verse 2, "And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from the Most High out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband." And New Jerusalem represents the nation of Israel, man, the elect being beamed back down into the earth. It's a people before a city, you know, after that, that heavenly, ceremony, you know, drinking wine anew. With Yahweh Shai, you know, the crowning, you know, 2 Esdras, you know, the crowning of the elect, those that stood so stiffly, you know, however long they're up there, that whole ceremony, you know, being up there with Yahweh Shai, and then they're going to be beamed back down at some point, you know, and they're going to go throughout the earth, you know, purging out the rebels and chaining up these elites and the remnant of these heathen nations for 1,000 years of captivity that's coming, man, you know. So verse 2, "And I, John, saw the holy city Jerusalem coming down from the Most High out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of the Most High is with men," the Israelites, the elect, man, that governing body, "and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and the Most High himself shall be with them and be their power. And the Most High shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." All of those things aforementioned are things that Jake are going through and dealing with to this very day here under this oppressive, afflictive captivity that we've been in, you know, under these devils, man. all those things are going to pass away. You know why? Because they're going to get burned up. Revelation the 20th chapter in verse 14, you know, and death and hell was cast into the lake of fire. It's the second death, man. You know, so it's going to pass away, man. Those thermonuclear missiles is going to hit this place and destroy all of that. All of that things aforementioned, the tears, the crying, the sorrow, the death, all that's going to go away, man. Verse 5, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. You know, Isaiah 55 and 11, the Lord says his word does not come back to him void, but it shall accomplish the thing whereto he sends it. You know, it's all about the will and purpose of the Lord, man. You know, so he said he makes all things new, man. New. Right here on earth, everything is going to be made new, man. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to be right here on earth, man. You know, but everything is just going to be new, made new, you know, refreshed, you know, we ain't going nowhere, man. You know, if you do happen to be one of those chosen to pass away, you're going to come back, man, you know, but everything is, the kingdom of heaven is going to be right here on the earth, man, you know. So, you know, hopefully this was edifying to the hopeful elect. With that, giving all praises, honor, and glory due to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Kakadash, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and blessings to the elect, the house of David, the Bayath, Shah, Dawadah, Shalom.